Here is one example of the so-called top-down parsing with the same grammar as before. Top-down parsing is very, very close to the derivation I showed you before. So, we now have here our table, and well, here I draw you a little tree, so the dot tells you where we currently are. So we are starting with our tree. Here we have, in the first column, we have our input that we want to check if it's in our grammar. Then on the stack, like in the derivation I showed you before, we start with our start symbol. And here we have the rule that tells us how we derived those lines. So this one looks oddly similar to the deduction I showed you in the logics video. So, top-down parsing knows basically two rules. If you don't count the initialize one, which you're only using once. So top-down parsing knows two other rules, which are called scan and predict. And the predict, that is like the derivation step, we have our non-terminal at the beginning of the stack, and we have some production rules from our grammar, and we are just exchanging those non-terminal symbol by the right-hand side of the production rule. So because the top-down parser, it has no foresight like a human, so it doesn't know which rule will be successful in deriving those words. So it has to try out every rule that is there. So here, this looks very similar again to the logics deduction. So we are applying a predict step on line 1, once with those rules, so S expands to ASB, exchanging those S by ASB, so we are left with AS and B on the stack. And another time, all but also on line 1, but with another rule, the top-down parser tries out this rule, exchanging S by AB, so we are left with AB on the stack. Now, the next rule the top-down parser has, it is called scan. If you are looking at line 2, we have the same terminal symbol here at the beginning of the rest input, and it's also the same on the stack. So with the rule scan, we can just delete both. So if from line 2 we are deleting the first A, we are left with the second A and followed by BB. And if we are deleting the A from the stack on line 2, then we are left with the non-terminal S at the beginning and the B behind that. So we deleted the A from that. And we can only do it if they are both at the beginning and if they are the same terminal symbol. Now, here on this stack, the top-down parser is a little bit stupid, so it also will also perform a scan step on line 3. But after that, because on this stack at the beginning we have a non-terminal symbol, on line 4 the top-down parser will try out another predict step. So here's scan, which is, as you can see, now those two strings are completely different, so the parser can't do anything more with them. But on this line 4, it can try out both rules that we have again. So exchanging those S one time by ASB, which are the first three symbols, and the B that was behind the S is just kept. And then again, it tries out the other rule on line 4, exchanging the S by AB, and as you can see here now, the rest input and the stack are the same here, so line 7 will lead us to a successful path in the next few steps. So, but first it has to do another scan step on line 6. This was this one. And then it can start to scan on line 7. So, as before, it means that the first terminal symbols on rest input are stacked on the same, so they can just be removed from both. But on line 8, we also have the non-terminal at the beginning, so it will, the parser will try out on line 8, which is the non-terminal at the beginning, will try out both routes for the parsing again for the derivation and exchanges them by the right hand side. As you can see, these are even too long for the left hand side, so they will not be successful. But from line 9, which has the two B's on both rest input and stack, it performs a scan step, so we are left with the last two B's, and then it can do a scan step again on the both B's and erases them both. And in computational linguistics, we love Greek symbols. So this one is an epsilon. This is our empty string. So it means it's a string of length 0. So maybe in those lines there would be nothing, but we symbolize it with those epsilon. And the parsing of top-down is successful if both rest input and stack are empty, which is here the case. That means the parsing was successful and the rest input, the input we started with, is a word derivable by our grammar or is in our language.